Hello and assalamu alaikum. Today our topic is breathing systems. Delivery of anesthetic gases from anesthesia machine to patient is done through this breathing system. Here you can see in this picture anesthesia machine delivering anesthetic gases to patient. Breathing systems which we will discuss today are insufflation, open drop, Mapleson circuits and circle system. Insufflation: there is no rebreathing of CO2 with a high flow of fresh gas. This type of breathing system is normally used in pediatric inductions because children don't let a face mask to be placed on their faces. Ventilation cannot be controlled by insufflation. In open drop, an anesthetic like ether is dropped on a mask, patient breathes this vaporizer. Disadvantages of insufflation and open drop anesthesia are: depth of anesthesia cannot be controlled through these two. Ventilation cannot be controlled. Heat and humidity cannot be conserved. And patient breathing out CO2 and other anesthetic gases can pollute the operating room. Third is Mapleson circuits. Problems of insufflation and draw over anesthesia or open drop anesthesia are solved by Mapleson circuits. Mapleson circuits are classified into these classes A, B, C, D, E, F, and the parts of this circuit are fresh gas inlet, a reservoir bag, a breathing tube, an APL valve. Fresh gas inlet is the inlet for anesthetic gases, and its position is the key factor in the performance of these Mapleson circuit classification. Breathing tubes are normally made of rubber or plastic, and the volume of these tube should be at least greater than the tidal volume. The volume of this tube should be at least greater than the tidal volume of a patient. Fresh gas enters through this inlet and patient takes up anesthetic gases. The patient exhales CO2 and the rest into this breathing system back, but the fresh gas is continuously coming in, so the pressure builds up inside this breathing circuit, so APL valve allows this pressure to be relieved through it. Spontaneous ventilation is the ventilation when patient breathes on its own, and controlled ventilation is when we control the ventilation of a patient through a ventilator. During spontaneous ventilation, when the patient is breathing on its own, the APL valve should be completely open. The fresh gas is continuously coming in and the patient is breathing on its own. When he exhales, the valve should be opened to let the gases go out. And during controlled ventilation, this APL valve should be closed during inhalation to build the pressure required, and should be open during the exhalation to let the gases out. Now, efficiency of these breathing circuits depends on the requirement of fresh gas flow, which is required to eliminate the CO2 exhaled by the patient. Patient should not rebreathe any of CO2 exhaled by him. Mapleson class A is ideal during spontaneous ventilation because fresh gas required is almost equal to minute ventilation, and Mapleson circuit D is ideal for controlled ventilation. You can see here fresh gas inlet is close to the patient, and here fresh gas inlet is away from the patient. APL valve is close to the patient. This APL valve during spontaneous ventilation will allow the exhaled CO2 and other gases to pass out through this APL valve, and during controlled ventilation by a ventilator, this will let a buildup of pressure inside this circuit. That's why it's ideal for controlled ventilation, and Mapleson A circuit is ideal for spontaneous ventilation. Bain circuit is the modification of Mapleson D class